Jay Shrek.
And James.
And who else? Jen. We're ready to get it on today. We are back. Look at this. No big lava rocks that I got to kind of stumble over. No Agua Fria madness. What I got today is, look at this. Look at this. Damn, I'm ready to go. This is good hiking. And we're going to go back to Gila Bend. Well, we're already back. But what we're going to get is, there's a secret location. And you know how I like secret locations. Don't tell anybody what we're going to do. We got a secret location from a California person that says that we've got some petroglyphs down in this canyon that no one knows about. And we're going to go down this canyon and see what we can find. You ready to go, James?
Yeah, let's go see.
I am pumped up today. You know, it was only about 40-something, but you know what the nice thing was is that there's no real wind. And I'm going to say that, and the wind is going to start. But this should be a great trip because these should be some really special, special petroglyphs. We're going to walk down this canyon. And we're going to see what we find down here. I think we're going to walk the outside edge, though.
Take the higher ground.
Well, you know, they always say take the higher ground, right?
Yeah.
So if they say that, there's a reason. So we should do that. We should follow and take the higher ground. What a day. What a beautiful day. Not a cloud in the sky. We got the moon still up. Got the sun on this end. Got the moon on this end. It don't get any better than that. I am really stoked about this because we're in a location that a lot of people, well, most people have never seen. All we got to do is find it, though, and that's not always the easy part. You know, James, I think a lot of people think that, you know, it's easy to do this. And, you know, sometimes you stumble into it, but sometimes, boy, it is a hell of a lot of work to find specific locations.
Well, there's no street signs. It's not going to the Circle K out here.
And you do got to get out of your car or truck.
Check those out.
Oh, wow. That's got to mean something. Let's go look at those. Well, you know, it just looks like it's
big mountains in the middle of nowhere. Go look at them. It's probably something.
Well, you know, it's off the road.
It is.
And so
we've seen these before. We saw them over at Oakman.
Now, we do know there's a ranch over here.
Yeah, no, these tend to be surveyors because there's one to your left with a pole in it. But they're always worth
checking out. Boy, this is funny, though. It really is. It's kind of...
Yeah, you never know. But there's a third one over here with a pole in it, so it was a surveyor's marking. It might actually have a marking on the top. I see a little knob on that one.
Little trail that runs through here, and it's pretty prevalent. So is that a survey marker? Don't touch it!
1934.
Wow. That's pretty incredible, really.
Yeah.
You know, what's really funny about this trail is I mean, we're out in the middle of nowhere, and look how prevalent this trail is. This isn't something that somebody, a couple people walked, right? This is something that a lot of people walked. You wouldn't get a trail like this just out in the middle of nowhere if this wasn't a trail that would lead somewhere. So I'm looking at the fact that this has got to go somewhere. And look how deep that canyon gets that quick. Look at that. Isn't that crazy? I mean, it doesn't take long for all of a sudden you've got a canyon that's extremely deep.
Do we want to be down into that?
You know, I think we do. I was kind of digging on this trail, but I agree. We need...
Well, I would imagine this is one of those old ones. So it will go to the peak of, or the tip of this point, and we're going to want to be below it, correct?
Yeah, I...
John's coordinates?
Oh!
Oh!
I feel like I'm back at Agua Fria.
Yeah, the lava's no fun. And I think it's fun, but it's not like easy. You have to be careful because none of it's as stable as it looks.
You know what's funny is you don't take a lot of this stuff, like when you do what we do, you don't take a lot of these smaller trails serious, but you still need to, you know? You still need to look at where the hell you're going. Look at this run. Isn't this cool?
More easy everyone would be out here. I would be somewhere else.
This is a nice little run of rock through here. I didn't.
I don't know. I mean, them. You were too close to it. You would have had to deal with the mess. And you wouldn't have had fun with that one.
It'd have been a mess. Look at that canyon. How beautiful is that?
Yeah, I know. I was hoping it would open up like this.
Well, and there's opening right on.
Yeah, exactly. So, it kind of worked out like we thought it would. Short of more petroglyphs down on this end, huh?
But I would like to walk this rim.
Well, that's why I figured.
While we're here.
I figured it was easier walking than down in the canyon at that point.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I don't know how deep that is. I'm not going to take a.
It looks like it might.
There's a lot of people that believe that the moon landing was faked here.
I can see that. And the fact that there's a lot of bushes.
Look, here, they went like this.
Show me. Moonwalking.
And then they went.
Oh, look at that.
Walking on the moon. Do, do, do. So, let's see. Wasting my time away. Okay. I wonder if John's.
He's at 1915.
1915.
So I kind of know exactly where he's at.
Yeah, I remember 1915. 1915 is probably the guy that blew that shit off the wall.
I was just thinking that's probably the case. Or his answer, or his children.
Picked the pieces up after he blew himself up. Our big rock squished him.
Expecting him down in the 30s.
Here we go. Look at there. Here. Now that's an ancient trail.
Ancient trail.
Right there. Look at that thing, man. That thing. And you can see, right? It makes so much sense. It goes probably right to that waterway. And then the shortcutters, even back in the day, somebody trying to short the journey. Hey, if anybody does this, what's the scoop with the four piles of rocks? What is the scoop to that? It's got to be something to it. So that's 36. The other one down the way was 34.
Yeah.
So that at least they spent 2 years out here or came back in 2 years. Now I'm wondering if there's anything on these walls. Which now I kind of wish I was down in the valley, but that's not how it worked out. Boy, that's a good cliff right there.
Yeah, no, we got up here, man.
Famous. So you look at that and you go, okay. Why did they use those? It's the point. I'm actually ecstatic just walking this trail because I know I'm hanging out like they did thousands of years ago. They walked this trail. Whether they walked down to the water hole or, you know, or wherever, they were strolling through here, and I mean, this is, because you know, there's the trail, I mean, that somebody made a trail through that,
yep.
And so you just know how prevalent it is. This is really... Look how green the desert is today. It's just incredible. The colors, the greens, just the greens themselves against this chocolate background. How unbelievable is this? So, I mean, I was hoping to get in some petroglyphs somewhere in this, but you know, I don't see anything. So, and again, it goes to show you that there had to be a purpose and a reason. They just weren't tagging everything.
Yes, I firmly believe there was significance to the locations that you find them. It takes too much time to make one to do it arbitrarily.
Right there is somebody in that ditch or something moving. See it? Straight through here, all the way. Yeah, it's moving. You know, one thing, James, that I just noticed was this hunting blind right here. Stack rocks right in here. And then this would have been a hunting blind right here, facing down to the creek below. Easy access to get back in. This definitely was a hunting blind right here. Stacked right in there. Those are definitely stacked rocks.
Yeah.
Had a nice windbreak back here, looking across. Good place to check and see if maybe he left some remnants. Man, an arrowhead would be a nice, that'd be nice, wouldn't it? And you know they would have been in here with them.
Well, yeah, if this is an old-timey blind.
They definitely stack rocks up here. There's just no doubt. There's that guy moving across.
Well, that's the only thing. I mean, you know, I would guess this is old, like, you know, original, but there is modern hunting up here quite a bit. That's why there's, like, some relevance to, you know, because they're not going to sit if they hunt somewhere. They're not going to sit and peck out rocks, making noise, leaving all kinds of indicators of their presence. Because, you know, they're going to keep certain areas so that there's not unmistakably something here. How long ago? Who knows?
Well, I don't see anybody coming out here and building that unless it's ancients, right?
Well, I mean, and I do know there's modern hunters hanging out up here, but that doesn't necessarily mean they take the time to do this. Although it doesn't necessarily mean they wouldn't, too.
Well, first you got a barren area too, right? And I think this was a shelter. I'm going to go this was a shelter.
It could have been, absolutely.
I'm going to go it was a shelter. Isn't that kill you, though, that you think about? That could have been 1,500, 2,000 years ago. Ancients built those rocks, man. They put their hands on them.
It doesn't necessarily mean they take the time to do this.
That is old.
Yeah.
Look at that. Almost looks like some type of blasting cap.
That's interesting.
I don't recall seeing. Now that looks like, man, that looks like it hit something. Wait a minute, that's something.
That's threaded, isn't it?
Well, no, that's smashed.
That's smashed, really?
That's that.
Oh. Huh.
Did he hit, what the hell is that? Can you
let me see.
What the hell is it? You know, we found these shells, and you know, I can't help, and maybe it's not that old, but man, I can't help but think about, you know, man, we saw an 1849 graffiti down there. I mean, my gosh, that's 170 years old. 170 years ago, somebody was down there. That's a couple lifetimes, right? I mean, that's like, I mean, I'm just astonished that, you know, people were down here. So when you see these shells, you know, maybe it was 20 years ago, but hell, maybe it's 100 and something. I'll be curious to see when we get back, you know, how old these shells are.
Yeah, we're going to have to look it up, man.
Because that is still...
I'll have to look up the company that's printed on them and the caliber and see what they are.
Pretty neat deal. Then look at here. What's this? Is that an animal? Or? Yep, yeah, absolutely. There might be a coyote in there.
That's a coyote den.
A little coyote.
It should be a coyote den. Little babies down there.
Little babies. You know, they were all above, they were all along these mountains, this mesa, right? I mean,
Well, people for the last 2,000 years have frequented this area, lived this area from the, you know, early, you know, original settlers of this area 2,000 years ago all the way to, well, now we got ranchers even still, so it tells you.
Definitely trails right there.
Yeah, there's three right here.
Isn't that cool? Another one right here. You know, real similar to the trails we have, hiking trails, right? I mean, everybody cuts something off, right? You know, now look at those rocks. Now tell me those aren't, there ain't no way those are stacked like that. I mean, just haphazardly. See that row right here? There ain't no way these are all in a line.
Oh, that's something.
Right here and here. There's no way.
Oh, bright spot in the desert, especially in Gila Bend. We have not seen standing water.
Which means that, you know, that means that we're here. I mean, that's what it should mean.
Well, it should mean that this would have been a great resource out here. Even at the time of the river running, if you were a little further off of the main river, that this had been a good resource to...
Isn't that funny?
Take advantage of. That's beautiful.
Look how deep this thing got this quick. You know, that's what's pretty incredible.
Down here.
Yeah, let's take a look and see what we got.
The canyon itself is. Well, it just shows you, even today with the different climate that we have, it's like these seasonal parts of the desert can be like little oases, man. This is awesome. Look at that.
Well, it makes the total, and look what you see around them. There it is. It's right where the water is. There's petroglyphs right there. That is so funny.
Good water.
Look at this.
There's another one right here.
Funny.
Cool, man. This is awesome.
Right here?
I live here. All the way up that wall, you'll see those lifts too. Look at that.
How crazy is this?
That's pretty cool, man. I'm getting my shadow out of this out here, but...
this is like... This is really neat. Wow, this is...
Oh, there's some old ones right there.
Man, this is... James, I'm telling you, this is special. That's a guy right there. There's a warrior.
Yeah. There's a big hand, big feeder.
Wow.
They're all...
Wow. I tell you what, this is really the real deal. Who had ever thought this would have been here? Wow.
Yeah, this is really similar to the ones I've seen in around Tucson, like the Saguaro National Forest.
Well, there's some crazy... Well, you know, everybody would have known about this, too. It wouldn't have just been them. This... I don't know. This is really, really a cool, cool place. You might see stuff popping out. You know, I don't know what that is, right?
That was something.
Looks like an 8
it
kind here.
Of looks like it might have been a date at one point.
And then this is a pretty deep. Man, that's been pounded out. And then this man here, he's like, where's the water? And he's like, there it is right there. See that?
Hole right there. This might not lose much water throughout the year, in fact. Because that's really deep right there. I didn't realize it with the moss in front, or the algae.
Well, the algae shows there's water that's been here a long time. Yeah. You know, it wouldn't grow algae unless this was a...
So I would say in June, there's probably not water in this. Or it's very low. But look at that right there. That's like a pool. You could like drop down in that and get to your...
John, jump in here real quick. See how deep this is.
Okay.
You bring your swim trunks?
Something, are you not filming now?
1 second.
You know, one thing that you notice when we're coming down this canyon is you don't see, they're not everywhere. So as James was saying, there was either respect or an indicator, but the petroglyphs had a purpose, because they're in specific locations. So now you can kind of look at, well, I don't know exactly how to interpret them, but I can interpret the fact that there was some either signage, respect. Now look at this 1915 by KJ.
Out in the middle, okay, of where there's no others.
Yeah, he just tagged it,
we
right?
We haven't seen any, yeah, over a couple hundred feet in either direction, and then KJ come over.
And then he put it up there just to tag it. I think we might need John's D stretcher on this one. Only because I know this sounds weird, but you don't see fine lines, right? You see a lot. Most of the petroglyphs have these kind of fat, you know, marks, right? Fat lines. So when you see something like this, and it's so hard to see because of that sun, but see those little lines, that little design in there?
Yeah.
I mean, that's just different. See, you're used to this, right? You're used to those big fat lines, not these skinny lines.
Yeah, no, those are a little bit.
Oh, and look at these guys. Oh, yeah, look at these guys back here.
Yeah.
Look at that guy on the point.
There we are. Nice. Good stuff, man. This is a cool little spot. I'd hang out here.
Well, I don't even think we've unleashed and unlocked all this stuff.
49.
Oh wow, where's that at?
Right there, straight across.
I thought I
see
saw
the sun.
Oh wow.
1849, that was a while ago, man.
You know, is that the oldest one yet?
That might be the oldest pioneer shit I've seen. I can't remember, because I think we've seen something else 1840, but it's all 1850s, 1860s usually.
I'm thinking we had something. When was the gold rush?
1849, the 49ers.
Wow.
So those guys were moving on over to California in the 49 gold.
And there's D.
We got RTH or BTH. I got DE. Cool, man. That's really neat.
That is one of my favorite, more modern petroglyphs right here.
And somebody, huh?
Man.
OWR and someone. 1849.
That's unbelievable. That is unbelievable. And you know, James, this is so fascinating. I mean, there's water here, and there was water there then, right?
Seasonally.
And so that's why this is why this whole place exists. Look at that. That blows my mind.
This is a neat spot.
Man, that's 170 years.
Holy crap, there's some more over here.
171 years.
Very cool.
I tell you.
Speaking of those fine lines you were talking about, look at this little guy.
I mean, that's really, you know. Okay, there's those. That just means there's stuff everywhere. There's HG, I think. I wish HG, if he was gonna mark it, would have
given us a date.
Yeah. There. Then there's a weird one right here. Looks like a bug of some type.
I see that guy, yeah. Very, very cool, man. I like this water. It's a great color.
Well, I mean, oh, I about fell in. I mean.
I like it.
I'll tell you, this is pretty special. This is about as special as you're gonna get. Wow, how incredible. Man, I kinda wanna just hang out. You know it?
Well, for those watching who wanna do this, you should really hang out at some of these spots for a little bit. Try to minimize your impact on the area, but you will start seeing all kinds of different stuff come out as the sun changes. It's really the only way to appreciate it fully.
You know, the only thing we really haven't checked out is to see if anything was on top of that hill.
Yeah.
I mean, they've been sitting down here just like I am. Ain't no doubt. There. Then there's a weird. You know, when you come down this hill, You know, one of the things that would have been the most important thing in the desert would be water. And so when you come down here and you realize that there's a lot of places that are really cool, a lot of great petroglyphs, but this place was life and death. You know, this might be the difference between you surviving and not surviving. So when you come down to these watering holes, you really appreciate the fact that how important this was to everybody, you know, through the generations. So, you know, you see this kitchen, you see where they ground, and this would have been life and death right here. This might have been the difference between you making it. So when you see that glyph over there, was not really a glyph, it's 1849, but it kind of is, you know, that's 170 years old. And you see that warrior symbol. So everybody used this, the animals, the cultures, how important this really was to survival in the West. That's why this is probably one of the coolest places I think I've been in Gila Bend. Because it is just, it's the difference maybe between surviving and not surviving. And that's why it's so special to me. I love this. This is just, this is a special, special place.